And that Gordon sacrifice fly was the last run of the game as Seattle wound up winning the game by a score of 2-1. Let's go back out to Seattle to the massive broadcast booth. Baseball Hall of Famer Jim Palmer joining us now. And Jim, you seem like you were very complimentary about Josh Rogers' work tonight. What did you see?
Well, I thought he was better than he was the last time he pitched. You know, he didn't get the run support that he got against Toronto. I mean, this is, you know, both of those triples would have been home runs in Baltimore, but here they're triples. And, you know, Haneker was, you know, a 15-game hitting streak. I just thought he used his changeup better, thought he used his slider better. You know, this is a type of kid that because he has a good windup and he's left-handed, you know, you get him to spring training, you work with him, you get Scotty McGregor to talk about what all good lefties have, that little two-seamer, you know, work on the changeup. Slider was better, the changeup's better, and all of a sudden, you know, you work on your pickoff move, and you got a guy that can be, I don't know if he'll ever be a number one starter because he doesn't have that kind of arm strength, but he can be certainly somebody, as he did tonight, keep you in the ball games. You know, and but again, at the end of the day, we all know it's about run support. You pitch well. Very hard in this day and age if you don't get a lot of run support to win ball games. We saw that in Kansas City where, you know, three rookie pitchers shut down the Orioles offense, which, you know, this is a type of offense right now you dream to pitch against because, you know, Trumbo's got the knee problems. They don't have anybody in their minor leagues to bring up. I mean, there's no way in the world with expander rosters you expect Caleb Joseph to hit in the eighth inning. You don't have somebody coming off the bench to try to pinch hit. So we'll see if that changes. But, again, this is a good team to pitch against when we talk about pitching against the O's.
Jimmy, you know, I like Jimmy Yakubonis. There's a lot of things, you know, I know that are a little quirky about his delivery. He doesn't always stay behind the ball. But what do you think about him becoming a future starter on this ball club? What is he going to have to refine in order to go deep into ball games?
Well, I don't know if he'll ever start, to be honest, Depper. I'm not saying he can't, you know, but I saw him. I got his phone call from the guy, Dean Albany, the Orioles scout that signed him, and you know, I saw him and I called him and he didn't answer the phone, you know, after he pitched that game against the Yankees. Because I wasn't doing the game, but I was watching out in California. Very violent lower half. You know, you can't sync up your lower half and your upper half. You're not going to throw strikes. You know that as well as anybody. I saw him the day before the game. I said, I tried to call you. I didn't want to call you back and bother you. He said, well, I would have answered if I'd known it was you. But with that, I just said, you know, the orange stripe on your leg, I said, come up to your windup. You know, we saw him throw 96 tonight. Take the stripe of your leg to home plate. If you're going inside, stripe in your front shoulder to where you want to go. If you want to throw to the outside corner, take the stripe in your shoulder to the outside corner. He's got this violent windup. I don't think anybody can ever pitch with a violent windup. You know, you can be Bob Gibson where your line's good. You can be Kevin Apier where your line's good, and then you fall off. But you can't do it to generate arm speed. It just doesn't work. Can't pitch to both sides of the plate. So, again, I don't know if he'll start, but he pitched well tonight. You know, we saw yesterday Gil Martin pitched very well. Otherwise, these games wouldn't end. So, again, we get, you know, it's an opportunity for these guys. You know, guys are going to get opportunity. Just because you get it doesn't mean you're going to be with the ball club. So take advantage of it, whether you're hitting or you're pitching. So, again, there's a couple of good things that we saw tonight. Rogers was one of them. But again, you know, Villar's your hitting hero. But if we're going to rely on him hitting solo home runs in back-to-back games for your only offense, we're not going to win a lot of games.